Hello, welcome to the first of hopefully several Red and Green podcast editorials. With the end of 2020, how to sum up the year?
This whole thing fucking sucks.
Oh yeah, it sucked.
Yeah, 2020 is pretty bad.
It wasn't the best year.
Yeah, and everyone thought 2016 was bad.
Yeah. I'd say 2017 actually, was worse for me.
Well, 2016 was actually all right up until November.
Yeah.
At least I wasn't fucking depressed in 2020. Jesus, I know. Like, yeah. How could I not be depressed? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's definitely. Yeah. All right.
Well, I think 2020 was like it started off all right, and then it didn't, and then it stopped being all right.
Yeah.
It's definitely the year that wasn't like.
Yeah, but now with it behind us, we can all look towards a better tomorrow. Of course, there was plenty of stuff in the 2020 that was good, several anniversaries and great shows and movies to come out. But let's look towards the future, shall we? So, the three of us, myself, Red, and a special guest, again, Equestron, have ourselves a short list of some things that we think are going to happen and some things that we really want to happen this year of 2021. We're going to be going over our what we think is going to happen first, and then go into our wild speculative wish lists afterwards. So why don't we start off with you, Equestron. What do you think is going to happen?
I'm going to get off my butt and make more things for YouTube.
Let's go.
Well, not strictly what we were looking for. Yeah, that's promising. Thank you.
Yeah, because I mean, it's not like the stuff I made for 2020 was bad or anything like that. I loved doing what I did, but I just wish I made more of it. So that's something I hope to improve upon in 2021.
Yeah, we can call that your New Year's resolution.
Yeah.
Yeah, but strictly what we're thinking about is predictions and wish list stuff for stuff in the media, like movies, how they'll do, TV shows, anime, games, and how we, like, announcements and stuff that's already announced will hopefully be good or maybe bad.
Let's see. I mean, like, most of my wish list is just about more, like, post-pandemic things, like, hopefully things will open back up. Hopefully the vaccine becomes more widely available. And I hope that things start to come back to a general normal, be 100%, but at least getting there. I mean, those are really my, and then I just hope to go out into a movie theater for once. It's been quite a while.
Yeah. I went to a movie theater like a month ago. It was not great.
Yeah, like because the last I saw Tenet and then that was it.
I saw the War with Grandpa. That was not great.
No one knows what that is.
Yeah. Suffice to say, you'd rather not see it. Except for Christopher Walken, that was the highlight though.
Yeah, Christopher Walken's career has gone south. Let's just say it.
Yeah, alright. Red, how about you give us an example of what you think is going to happen next year?
Okay. I think the rest of the Smash Fighter pack is going to get announced. I don't think it's going to be, but, like, I think the last one's going to really make people go crazy, but the two in between I think are going to be pretty underwhelming. I do predict that all the characters that they release on the fighter pack are going to be really meta-defining and really annoying to fight against. As far as, like, Nintendo itself, I think they're going to keep having their most profitable year. They're going to release another game that's a huge success, and I think that'll be Breath of the Wild 2. It's going to be, like, super beloved. I think Mario Odyssey 2 will be announced, but it won't be released next year, and if it is, it's going to be, like, the holiday title. I think Pokemon is going to either have a outright new game or just make more DLC, which that's still not clear what direction they're gonna go. I don't know how successful the DLC pack was.
I'm just going to interject and say what I think is going to happen with Pokemon, specifically as far as a prediction and not a wish list item. I think they're either going to have Let's Go Johto or Gen 4 Remake because they've already released the DLC that they set out for Sword and Shield, and I think they're done with that.
Yeah, I think Nintendo's going to dip their toe into microtransactions, which more so than actually dip their foot at this point because they already have dipped their toe into it. So what? How that pans out is going to be really curious. I don't know if Raya and the Last Dragon was announced for 2021, but either way, I still predict that that film is going to just be seen as like worse Moana. Like that's really going to be held over its head, just kind of like. Like how Soul is always held over Inside Out's head now, it's like, yeah, I think Rey is gonna have a very similar problem, and it's like gonna be a weird comparison, but I feel like that's gonna be really significant.
Yeah, Raya was announced for 2021, supposed to come out in March, I believe.
Oh,
Maybe
wow, that's
April.
soon.
Yeah, it's gonna be, Disney Plus exclusive, of course, because for obvious reasons.
Yeah, let's go. I feel like Warner Brothers catalog is going to be really panned. I don't think Tom and Jerry is going to be really critically praised. Like all their films look kind of okay right now.
Yeah, if only they
I don't
would
know.
go back and use the original sound effects of Tom and Jerry instead of just like.
Yeah, remember when they changed it from a cat voice because it wasn't funny and then they changed it back?
Do ah!
Like Tom's scream is like one of the best fucking screams like ever. And they're like, we
That's one of the
don't
best screams because it's such a human scream, and that's what makes it so funny.
that. Yeah, it's like no one wants to fucking beat the shit out of a cat. That's fucking bad. It's like, why is that
Yeah.
fucking funny scream? Like, yeah, that's so awkward. I think the Monster Hunter movie is gonna be fucking horrible. I think like, you know what every review is gonna say when they're doing Monster Hunter shit? It's great. When it's doing like Michael Bay shit, it's awful.
Yeah, I haven't heard great things about it. Did you know that it was banned in China after one day?
Yeah, I'd believe it.
I mean,
Did they make a? Yeah.
yeah, they made a not so PC joke about China, and they're like, nope, you edit this out
Wait,
or
wait,
else we're
wait,
banned.
wait, 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 wait. Wait, wait. They made a not PC joke about China in a Monster Hunter movie.
Yes.
It's a Chinese
Monster,
dragon.
does anybody not understand that Monster Hunter is in a fucking fantasy world that probably doesn't even have China?
Have you ever seen the trailer for the Monster
Yeah,
Hunter
they have
movie?
live action humans coming in, like who are military coming. Have you not seen
Yeah.
the trailer?
Yeah, they have like
Like,
modern day
there's a
soldiers
reason
and stuff
why
that
I
use the Monster
avoided the
Hunter universe.
trailer. There's a reason why I avoided the trailer because one screenshot from that thing was an instant fucking deterrent.
Yeah, like I think they'll announce the Last of Us movie series, whatever the fuck it is. I think it's gonna be really just like that franchise isn't really seen in a positive light right now, and it's like
I will also
under really
interject and
shaky
say that
ground.
I'm going to interject and say that I'm going to be buying Last of Us Part 2 before this PlayStation sale ends because I want to see for myself if it's good or bad. But there is one thing I will not stand for. It's crunch time and employee abuse, and no.
Oh yeah, they all do that, by the way. I hate to break it to you, but literally every game studio is doing that. They all do that real a lot.
Especially CD Projekt Red.
Yeah, like the like and EA has like notoriously done that for so much longer. I mean, I know why they are bringing it up now because there's gay people in Last of Us and they don't like that very much, but like
Wait, wait.
yeah,
Wait,
it's
hold on. What the hell would the correlation be then?
No, because you know, like, canceling's not just a left-wing thing. You know that, right? Like,
No,
if you're
no,
like,
no,
okay, I hate
no.
gay
No.
people.
What where the hell's the leap in logic between like LGBTQ and abusing employees?
No, because they're like, we need an excuse to like hate on this fucking game. Oh, well, if we say employee abuse, no one's gonna side with that. So if we say it's employee abuse, then we can inadvertently get the game that has lesbian shit in it in a negative light.
Wow,
And
how
that seems
fucking
to have worked.
petty can you be? Yeah, you must have
Yeah,
literally
like,
nothing to do in your life to do that shit. You must be so
yeah, like,
fucking
what the
bored and unemployed and a fucking piece of garbage to want
Yeah.
to even try that. It's just like, oh, I just want attention. Like you can yeah,
Yeah,
making
no,
fucking
you would be really surprised.
political tweets would get you more attention than that.
Yeah, but they can't. I'm not getting in a fucking political thing right now.
I
Like,
know, I
people are
know.
just
Yeah,
saying that
yeah,
stuff
yeah. I was
was
just making
dumb.
a
It
joke.
applies to
Well,
both sides, by the way. Don't
yeah. No, ma no.
agree
Yeah,
with
but let's agree that no
me.
matter what, 2021 will be better than the past 4 years. Wink, wink. Nudge, nudge.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else?
More predictions. Ruby season 8 or whatever the fuck season they're on, like that's gonna be even worse than the last one. I don't know. I'm so out of the loop on that franchise, but if I remember correctly, there's this next season. So each Ruby season has been covering a lesser time period. Season 1, it was like 3 years. Then it was 1 year. Then it was a few weeks. Then it's a few, like, and it's been a few weeks, like the past few seasons, but it's been less weeks. And now this new season is over 3 days.
Yeah.
That
What
is
is this, the fucking Endless
so
Eight?
bad. And my fucking, like, tinfoil hat theory on that is they fucking had the story written out all the way, so they're just dragging it out as long as possible so they don't, like, mess with Monty Ohm's vision, but they
I'm
don't
just gonna take
realize
a
they're doing
stab in
that.
the dark and say this is the new Dragon Ball Z.
No, it's worse than that. It's literally like they are padding for time so bad because I think they kind of know the ending's not very good, but we'll still have to pan out. My main prediction for Ruby is that Salem's gonna be redeemed, and that's how the story's gonna conclude. Like, they're gonna say, "Oh, we forgive you." Also, there's gods that came down in Ruby and shit, and she's cursed. I don't know if either of you have seen that show, but it's not
No,
good.
I've been watching it rather closely, because
Yeah.
I started watching it at the end of 2018, because I think that was when Volume 7 was starting off, and so I was like, okay, I'm gonna give this show a watch. So I bought like this box set of the first six volumes and just pretty much watched them, marathon them,
Yeah.
and then after that I watched Volume 7. I mean, yeah, like the show does have its issues. Like I'm not gonna be like, rose tinted glasses and be like, oh, this is the perfect series. Like you're just talking crazy. There's very few shows where I would act like that.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been personally enjoying it. I mean, I understand why some people don't like it, but I've been personally enjoying the series a lot. But yeah, like Volume 8 taking place over a period of only like 3 to 2 days. I heard the first I heard was 2 days, but now it's three. But
No, it's
I
probably
mean,
two.
yeah. But it's like, oh my God, like what are you gonna accomplish in 2 days? Because like you said, the last few volumes have taken place over a more lengthy period of time.
Yeah. And it's just, do you think they'll redeem Salem?
I mean, like I'm a huge Salem fan. So I personally wouldn't don't mind either redeemer or killer or something.
Because I can't see a reason like the gods wouldn't destroy the earth unless that is going to happen. Like, I think they're gonna try to make Cinder the real villain.
But I mean, I don't really expect a My Little Pony fairy tale kind of re resolution where they just redeem the villains, except for how My Little Pony Season 9 ended, where they didn't redeem the villains. It's like,
Cinder, I'm fairly confident, is gonna be like the real villain. Like, she's gonna get like all four of the fucking like
all seven
female
Chaos
villains and shit.
Emeralds.
Yeah, she's gonna be super shadow.
Because yeah, I mean, I could see that. I could see her becoming like, you thought Salem was the villain, but it was me, Dio.
Yeah, it's me, Jessica Negri, the whole time.
Now watch as I cosplay as Pikachu.
She will never cosplay Cinder. That is the one thing I think Jessica is, like, banned in her own mind, is she can't physically cosplay Cinder.
Well, that's unfortunate, because I think she'd be good. She'd do a good job.
She literally has the butt. It's so funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, but, I mean, I personally probably don't see them fully redeeming Salem. I mean, they'll probably do pull, like, a what they did with Volume 6 and, like, try to get you and try to further get you to understand her, but I don't think they'll totally redeem her.
Yeah. We'll have to see.
Yeah.
And now after that long Ruby tangent... And now after that long Ruby tangent...
Dude, Genlock fucking bombed. Like, that show does not exist anymore.
Well, it's gonna be on HBO Max.
Oh, it's still continuing? Holy shit.
Yeah, they're still making it. They haven't announced the release date, I don't believe, but
I'd like to correct a statement that I made a little earlier. I just purchased The Last of Us Part 2.
No, I'm
sorry. That's awesome. Yeah, because I was like, yeah, you know, I have enough to fucking cover this. Screw it. I'm just going to take care of it now. When is Last of Us Part 2 ever going to be under $30 again?
Probably, like, later in the year.
Like, I don't know. I just, like...
Next Christmas 2021.
No, and next Christmas it'll be, like, $9. It'll be free on the PlayStation Network.
Yeah, I would like to not make a prediction, but, well, actually, what I'm hoping is that, I guess I could just make this a prediction, that PlayStation 5 restocks go into maximum overdrive, to quote Plankton from SpongeBob, and they overstock to compensate, and, like, it's so overcompensated for the overstocking that literally there's hundreds of units in stores that don't go bought for, like, a few years.
That would be nice.
Yeah.
Like, how many did they sell, though? Because I'm pretty sure they had a pretty healthy launch. It's just many people bought a PS5.
They say that they've sold 3.4 million units already.
Oh, and,
that's pretty fucking crazy.
I know, yeah. And I can guarantee you this, by the next time we're doing this for 2022, I will have a PlayStation 5, if it kills me.
I will too. Yeah.
Because I cannot stand these horrendous, horrendous download times for the PlayStation 4. I'm looking at this right now. Last of Us Part 2, just to start it up, is 3 hours, and the rest of it is... Like, now it's 8 hours, it was 9 hours a second ago. Like, that's insane! And this is because... This is because little factoid, the original PlayStation 4 does not have a 5G compatible, like, chip or whatever. The PlayStation Pro does. So, that's why it was faster on top of having a, like, more powerful SSD. And because the PlayStation 5 not only has an even more fast and powerful SSD and the 5G compatibility, that's going to make reinstalling all these games onto there take a fucking breeze. Wait, that's completely wrong. Like, it take a snap of your finger. That's what I was trying to say. Anyway, yeah, well, while this... We'll check in back on the downloads at the end of this, but yeah.
Okay, what else is happening? Oh, I think Star Wars is gonna, like, start fading more as a franchise, because, like, Mandalorian kinda had, like, it didn't end, but it had a really, like, conclusive finale episode, and I feel like
everything Star Wars
is gonna be completing with Mandalorian.
Yeah, I mean, they already announced, like 11 Star Wars stuff.
Yeah, it's like, are all of these really gonna stand out as much as Mandalorian? Like, obviously they're not.
Yeah, well, what was funny is that initially they announced 10, but then at the end of the new season of Mandalorian, they're like, oh yeah, and there's also a Boba Fett spinoff, so now there's 11 of them.
Yeah. I think Buzz Lightyear movie's not, that's 2 years from now, but, well, it's actually next year, because we've started this year, but...
Yes.
That's not gonna go very well, but we'll save that for the next time we do this. I think Teen Titans Go is going to last all the way through this year. I don't think that show's going anywhere.
Despite the
Teen Titans Go movie, to complete the trilogy.
Despite
I'm convinced that that series is going to last longer than SpongeBob. Like, it will live to see SpongeBob go down.
Well, with Camp Coral coming up, like, SpongeBob might actually die. Already
lasted longer on the air than the original. Yeah, SpongeBob, I think, might actually... We might live to see that, which will be nuts, because, like, we've seen... We've pretty much all grown up with SpongeBob, like, through its whole lifespan, so... To see SpongeBob go, it's like, what's gonna happen? Because, like, Sponge on the Run, if it's written like that from now on, like, I don't think it has much of a chance.
Yeah, suffice to say, Sponge on the Run was god-awful.
Yeah, I was actually surprised to hear that it wasn't very good, because I thought the trailer was kind of funny, but that was probably because Keanu Reeves showed up, and so I was like, oh, cool, this movie's gonna be awesome.
Yeah, what if I told you that those were all the best jokes in the movie?
Oh, that sucks. That's what makes me disappointed with comedies, is when all the best stuff is in the trailer.
You spoiled it! Spoiled it! Spoiled it! Spoiled it!
Fuck. Like... What else is going on? What's another?
Disney Plus.
Oh, yeah.
What?
American Dragon still won't come to Disney Plus. That's my fucking prediction.
I actually have a prediction that contradicts that. Hold on, give me a second. Yeah, I just had to take care of something because I bought up those games. All right. My prediction for Disney Plus, and these are predictions, not wants. Because I still want these things, but I think there might actually happen. For Disney Plus, I'm predicting some favorites like Yin Yang Yo, House of Mouse, and American Dragon Jake Long will make their way to Disney Plus.
And I don't even think... Can that legally... Who owns that? I didn't even think about that.
Technically, it is under it because it was a collaboration between the Walt Disney Company and this other one. I'm pretty sure it can actually happen because I'd like to think that... Wait, actually, no. If I'm not mistaken, it actually is released on iTunes, but I could be wrong about that. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure... Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is possible. But I'd like to think that like all those shows in that era of Disney are finally going to show up.
I know for a fact now that the Buzz Lightyear like straight to DVD film will not release on Disney Plus until the CG one comes out because they don't want it competing with that film, which I understand because the 2D Buzz Lightyear film is obviously going to be better. But
I do like that Chris Evans is going to play Buzz because I mean if you can think of any all around American hero, I guess that's the guy.
Because like. As much as I know that that's just like, oh, he's good with Marvel, that's why he's in the role, like, they're trying to, like, advertise through the actor, and, like, it is a little sleazy from that angle, but at the same time, no fucking way is Tim Allen doing an emotional role, not in a million years.
Hey, yo!
Like, they hired
you killed him! Did not!
Specifically... What?
I was imitating the Santa Claus.
Yeah, like, they hired that guy as Buzz specifically because of his acting style. Like, how he kind of, like, doesn't emote well, because Buzz is, like, an over-the-top character.
Buzz Lightyear to Star Command, can you read me? My ship!
They know to, like, use that actor correctly, and they're like, no way is this guy going to be able to handle this role.
Yeah, like, Tim Allen's, he's a very, like, deadpan actor sometimes. Like, in a good way. Like I usually like his comedy, at least his early stuff. I haven't seen how he is lately, but he has that voice that's like
he's like the everyman instead of like the big action hero. Voice,
but that's why he was
on Home Improvement.
Yeah, it's like, but it's not like he can't do dramatic acting. But I assume, what they have planned for Chris Evans's version of Buzz Lightyear will probably be far beyond what Tim Allen can do.
Yeah, like I think we all. Like, that's the only reason...
Oh, wait. I have a prediction for that Buzz movie. I have a prediction for that Buzz movie. At the end of it, it's gonna be like fucking But
you listen to infinity and beyond and go into space. I bet $1 million.
No, that's obvious. But what I'm thinking will happen is that, like, a mid-credit scene will show, like, fucking the toys actually watching it on Blu-ray at what's her name?
They'll watch
Bonnie.
It on Disney Plus.
They'll be watching it at Bonnie's house. And it's like, that guy sounds nothing like me.
That's how they're gonna end the movie, or not? I mean, they're gonna mid credits or post credits scene. That's what they're gonna do.
And that guy doesn't oh like my me.
God, that's so funny.
And speaking of funny mid credit sequences, go into my Marvel predictions, WandaVision will be good. I mean, because Doctor Strange 2 is going to end with Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man. Like the post-credit scene, well, the mid-credit scene or whatever, is going to have, Doctor Strange, like, having all these open portals, and then, like, Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man just, like, runs up and says, pizza time. It's just like,
what did you say?
Oh, man. but it gets better. Spider-Man 3, which I'm going to be tentatively calling, what was it? The first one was called Homecoming. I forget what the hell that person, that guy had, like, a perfect name for this fucking movie. I don't remember what it was.
If it's Spider-Man coming back home, that will be hilarious.
No.
Far from home.
No
more home.
Oh my god, that would be fucking dark. No. It was something in. It had the word home in it, and also tied into the potential Spider-Verse angle. I'm trying to remember what the fuck it was called. That's really pissing me off.
Into the Spider-Home?
No.
Into the spider
home. I don't know. Fuck it. Homebound. I don't know. Whatever. At the end of that movie, Ryan Reynolds' Deadpool is going to come out of one of the portals.
Bullshit. If that happens, I will literally pass out.
Okay. But what were...
These are predictions, so, like, we'll see who's right and wrong.
Yeah. Deadpool has been kind of just slated to come to the MCU at some point, and I think this would be the perfect opportunity because Spider-Man and Deadpool have been synonymous with each other for years. And so Deadpool comes out of a portal and actually finally finishes the holy shit line that Spider-Man and Aunt May have been trying to finish for, like, the past two movies.
I don't think it'll happen, but I want that to happen so badly, because that's just the perfect ending.
Yeah, and that would be fucking incredible. I just, like, if there was a way to introduce Deadpool into the MCU, that has to be how you do it.
I would literally get a heart attack at that point. My body would be like, no, man, it's gonna get better than this. It's time to go, boy.
Yeah, alright, Alright, that's it for my Marvel predictions, because I don't know anything aside from the trailers about Black Widow or Shang-Chi or the whatever.
Which is why you should watch Game Theory, because, well, Film Theory, because he actually went into it. He's so much better now than he's been.
Hot take here. Don't really like MatPat.
No, he's so much better now. Like, yeah, he says really stupid shit still, but, like, he's so much better than he's been.
I'll take your word for it, but I don't have the time or tab space for him. Yeah, that's another thing I gotta do. I gotta get rid of all these fucking tabs. Alright.
I'll do it with you.
No, it's fine. It's fine. It's just, I need, like...
No, I want to.
No. No, if
me, he had 300 tabs open.
Oh,
like,
wow.
That was so funny. I have to see, like, what he needs to keep so badly.
It's not that I need to, it's just that I haven't had the attention span and time to go through them all and just get rid of the ones I don't need.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, any other predictions on your side, Red?
Smash predictions.
No. Are there any other ones aside from Smash
really.
Or no?
Like, I could go into every single dumb fuck franchise and thing, like, I know, but honestly, like, those are the main ones.
Yeah. Okay. My, I guess I might as well go into my Smash prediction then. This is prediction, not want, because the want is a lot more different. Okay. Sorry. Ugh. Gassy. Ugh.
I swear to God, if you say shunt.
No. That's for the
three,
wish. No,
two,
no.
One.
Go. All right. All right. Equestron, do you have any for Smash, or should we just go?
I do not have any Smash predictions.
All right.
I do have a film prediction.
Oh, actually, yeah. Go with that first. Go with that first.
In terms of HBO Max. The reception to the Snyder Cut will be the same as every other Zack Snyder movie.
No, you're right. That's just going to happen.
Yeah, like the people who love his work, like myself, will love it, and the people who hate it will hate it.
Yeah, he nailed it.
There will be no in between, and the discourse on his films will continue until the end of time, and it'll be highly annoying.
They'll say it's not the real Snyder Cut.
Yeah, or the people who don't like his work and who were against this cut happening will be like, "See, I told you it was bad."
Yeah. And then we're all just gonna laugh at them with champagne in our glasses up on a penthouse window. It's like, "Fah, you plebeians! We knew this would happen from the beginning."
I'll sit on my shrine of Zack Snyder Blu-rays being like, shut up.
Alright, okay. Alright, yeah. Let's see. Speaking of HBO Max, a little piece of good news. Like a lot of the cartoons from the 90s and early 2000s finally made it to HBO Max.
I'm gonna predict that Adventure Time is gonna really fall out of favor because they're gonna milk it too hard.
Is Adventure Time on HBO Max now? Other than the spinoff thing that they made?
I think it's just the spinoffs, but, like, I still think that that's really going to have a negative impact on the franchise. Like, I don't know what movie's going to do it. I would say by the fifth one, that's when people are going to be like, what's going on, guys?
How many of these things are going to make? I don't have time to do this. I have to take care of my children.
Oh, wait, I don't have any children.
No one who watches Adventure Time has children.
implying they ever got laid.
No, implying they can't have kids.
That's dark. Okay. Alright, now for my Smash predictions. I don't have a third one, like a final one, but I do have two. I'm predicting Crash Bandicoot will be the next fighter. And he will coincide with the release of Crash Bandicoot 4, It's About Time, for the Nintendo Switch. I'm predicting Master Chief will be after him, and that will coincide with the release of the Master Chief Collection on the Nintendo Switch as well. Potentially also with the Xbox Game Pass finally being released on it too. Hello?
Nintendo, they had no interest in doing a Game Pass, though.
Are you sure?
Yes, they said we have no interest in doing that.
Okay, maybe just like the Master Chief Collection or something, and then that's it. And then I don't have a third one. I'll bring up my wants, but a part of me kind of feels like there might be a third pack. I'm not entirely sure, but we'll get into that once again.
I will not pay for it.
What if Master Chief is the first character revealed?
I will not pay for it.
I will not pay for it, Sam. I am. I will not pay for this pack of cards.
You know how awful. Okay, Master Chief in Smash Bros. Would be the most toxic fucking character. He would be like all range. He'd be like Snake, but more annoying because he'd have sticky grenades.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think about that.
Zoinks!
The worst character. Like,
Zoink Scoob!
He'll take off his helmet and there will, his taunt will be taking off a helmet and there's another helmet underneath.
Like, he'd be like, he'll be like a Deathstroke in the Injustice games where he just shoots and throws shit at you.
It'll be just, that's, I'm so glad you said that, that's true.
I've never played that. Well, I have
a friend who played that, just like, my friend just mashed the fucking gunshots and he was like, he beat all my friends, they got so mad at him.
Alright.
Like, and apparently Rambo in Mortal Kombat 11 is just as broken as Deathstroke is.
Oh god. Will another 80s character be in Mortal Kombat 11? Place your bets.
The Universal Soldier, Jean-Claude Van Damme, will be the next one.
Okay, yeah, you're right, because Jean-Claude Van Damme, like, inspired Mortal Kombat. Dude, that'd be so hype.
No. Sean McClane from fucking Die Hard.
Oh, yeah. if they can manage to get Bruce Willis, I mean, he'll show up in any direct-to-video garbage, so he'll do Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
Featuring Bruce Willis as the voice of Spike in Rugrats Go Wild. I ate one of Chucky's diapers.
In those interviews, he's so depressed in those interviews. Like, I've never seen that guy so sad before.
I like that movie. Yeah, like,
he used to be happy and full of life, and now he just sounds sad. And I feel sad whenever I listen to him.
I ate one of Chunky's diapers one time, and let me tell you, that is spicy.
That's so gross.
Woof, that's right, I said woof.
Bruce Willis is one of those actors where you can tell that he doesn't care when you watch him in a movie.
Yeah.
Who wants a tongue back?
Like, into it, like, you could tell. It's like, but if he's not, like, the boredness is just there. Like, he's just like, oh, we gotta stop the terrorists. We gotta get out of here. What's wrong with you?
At least Arnie fucking has the energy. Like, get to the chopper! Go out!
At least when Arnold Schwarzenegger's in a bad movie, he'll still, like,
give eat my cookies! Put that cookie down! Now! He's gonna eat my cookies!
I couldn't stand the last Terminator movie that you did, but he was great in it.
You saw Dark Fate?
I did. Like, I see like a lot of movies, and I was like, oh, let's go watch. We'll watch Dark Fate, even after knowing about what happened in it, like in terms of John Connor. I was like, okay, well, I'll see how it goes. And yeah, it was just as bad as I feared it was going to be.
All right.
You had a rare experience because, like, no one saw that movie.
Yeah. Like, it was weird going there on, like, opening night and being, like, one of 10 people in the theater.
I went to Dark Phoenix opening night, and then, yeah, that was the same thing. Like, 10 people were there, maybe even less.
Alright. Yeah, actually, one of the more depressing opening nights I've ever been to was that Jack the Giant Slayer movie. You know, that one with that.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
holy shit.
Yeah, I went there, like, it was like opening night, 8 o'clock showing, and it was just me and my dad. And we're in the biggest theater there. And it's like, so it was like 500 seats. Only two people were there, me and my dad.
That is. That is kind of sad.
That movie bombed, like, extremely hard, though. Like, I think that's one of the worst ones, like, in history.
Yeah, so I was, like, looking around the theater going, man, this movie is gonna bomb.
Wow. Okay. All right.
Christian, you gotta flex your film knowledge more. People love to hear about that shit.
Yeah. All right. Okay, so... Alright. So now that we got pretty much all our predictions out of the way, if I'm not mistaken, I think we should move on to our pie-in-the-sky wish list stuff.
Ooh. That's like Master Chief in Smash for... No, that's Scorpion in Smash for me. I see that as, like, impossible. Like, that can't happen.
Alright. Equestron, let's start with you.
Cyberpunk 2077 being fixed.
Ooh! Oh, jeez, that's funny.
And keep in mind, folks, keep in mind, folks, that's a wish list item, not a actual prediction.
I mean, I've been playing it on the PlayStation 4 Pro. I've been having an okay time with it. Like there are times where it just runs smoothly. I'm like, all right, this is fun. And other times there's just some absolute jank. Like I've had quests being borked on me, being and going like, oh my god, I can't play this quest because there's a car in the sky and I can't get to it.
Beep beep.
And
Move out of the way.
so
I gotta get
it'll
to the
be nice
clouds.
that if the if, it'll be nice if the latest patches sort of fix that where the car is not in the sky anymore.
Guys, I can't believe Sonic 06 was the industry standard like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Like they
Yeah.
predicted the future.
Oh my, yeah.
Like,
I will eventually get Cyberpunk 2077, but one on the PlayStation 5 and two on the PlayStation 5.
It's
Like
meant for PC.
Yeah,
Yeah,
I
if
do
my
feel bad for
PC
the
can barely
developers.
yeah, my PC can barely run this call, I doubt that it can run Cyberpunk 2077.
Yeah, just put the settings all the way down.
And then
Yeah.
you'll get the PlayStation 4 experience.
More like PlayStation 2. More like PS2.
Oh
Wait, what? What?
Like, remember.
Oh my god.
Remember when people were like, oh man, I really hope that they port Cyberpunk to Switch in the future. Like, no, that's not gonna happen.
Like, no.
Oh
No.
my god, that was so
It's too bad I didn't fucking hear it.
Yeah, but yeah, I do feel bad for the developers at Cyberpunk, for
Yeah.
developers at CD Projekt Red. I don't feel bad for the higher ups who probably forced this on them. Like, I'm sure the developers were probably like, no, we gotta delay this thing like another 6 months. And they're like, no, we're not gonna do this. We need to get it out by the holiday season.
Yeah, they should have
And
just delayed it another year. Like, I think it would have been fine.
I would have
Yeah.
been okay. Like, I have plenty of other games to play. Like, another delay of Cyberpunk wasn't gonna change my world.
Yeah.
Yeah, like GTA 6 is probably like not gonna happen for a really long time. It's like there's longevity. It would have been worth waiting for to perfect.
Yeah, I
Yeah.
mean, I don't really care for Grand Theft Auto anymore.
Yeah, but like you can see, like, yeah, Grand Theft Auto 5, people are still playing that shit. It's like
Yeah.
Cyberpunk could have had that if they just waited, but now they've created such bad blood that I don't think they'll ever recover from it.
Yeah, I mean, it could end up being like a No Man's Sky situation where everyone hated it at first, and now today it's considered like a very loved game. But it's gonna take a while. It's not gonna be overnight.
But even then, like, there's a lot of people who still like hold on to that memory of No Man's Sky and never really checked up on it. Like that first impression, like you need to hit that because there's always gonna be people who like that is how they see the game for the rest of like time,
Yeah.
basically.
Yeah, and that is very unfortunate. But I mean, unfortunately, we do live in an age where patches and expansions improve upon things, and I kind of don't like it.
It's like. Because it encourages them to release busted ass games like this.
Yeah, and hopefully it doesn't end up like, I don't know, like Fallout 76. Where
Yeah,
no matter what they've done, it doesn't really improve upon it.
I've played Fallout 76 before. I've had a pretty decent time, but it was mostly my fault for what I've done in the game for an unpleasant experience.
What have you done? What did you do?
Not
What
up,
did you
not not upgrade the lessening weight for explosives thing. Because let's
Oh,
just say
so
don't
you
carry too many missiles until you get that fixed.
I'm just gonna carry all the missiles.
Right. Okay. So.
I think we should do your like pie in the sky predictions, and then we should end it because you said you wanted it to this to be like a shorter one.
What about yours?
Oh, mine's I just said Master Chief being in Smash Bros. That's the only one I really think.
Okay. So mine is a bit long, so I'll just try to quick fire through them.
Yeah.
Shantae, Amy Rose, and Phoenix Wright for Pack 2 and Pack 3 confirmation. For Smash Brothers. Pokemon Gen 4 remakes, using the best parts of Sword and Shield, but actually working on the graphics this time. Mario Galaxy 2 on Switch after the separation of the three games from the 3D All-Stars collection, all of which will be priced at $29.99 a piece. Because Nintendo.
That is highway robbery.
Because Nintendo. What else would you expect?
That'll happen. Does.
Yeah. Yeah, but well, that's what that's an expectation. What I want them to actually be is $20, $19.99 each.
They should be $5.
No, no. Oh, okay. Mario 64 should be $5.
Mario 64, $30.
I know. Yeah. All right. Let's just stop. Okay. Bayonetta 3 and Pikmin 4, Breath of the Wild 2, all at the very least show up at some point this year. Nothing significant.
Metroid Prime 4.
I was just about to get to that. Metroid Prime 4 as well.
Don't forget the Metroid Prime trilogy.
Yeah, I'm getting to that. Okay.
No,
shut up. This is my show. Well, this is our show. Alright, so Breath of the Wild 2, Bayonetta 3, Pikmin 4, and Metroid Prime 4 all at least show up at some point this year. I'd imagine Breath of the Wild 2 will probably get a big focus at E3 this year, or whatever June thing is going to happen. Honestly, Pie in the Sky would be just a fucking direct at all this year. Pikmin 1 and 2 Remastered and Metroid Prime Trilogy will also be announced. The Paper Mario Trilogy releases on Nintendo Switch for the last bit of Mario's 35th anniversary, like, the year to the day the 35th anniversary celebration would have been. It would be announced, pretty much similar, across the board, like, upscaling, 64 widescreen and upscaling for a Thousand Year Door and, like, I don't know, maybe just, like, better controls for Super. I don't get it. I don't know.
What?
Do the same fucking thing. I don't know. And just, like, and then fucking repeat it. Just, like, do them all separate the year after. Whatever. Pokemon Ranger game for Switch for Pokemon's 25th anniversary. Along with everything else already announced. New Pokemon Snap, Detective Pikachu on Switch. Whatever Pokemon's got in store for the mainline. Remake or otherwise. Let's see. Super Mario Party 2 gets announced.
Miyamoto retires.
We all wish, but anyway. Gameplay is more like Mario Party 6 and 7 as opposed to 1 and 2. Item list is a fusion of 3 and 7, which is something that I've always wanted from Mario Party, like, ever since I played 7 and 3. Nintendo
would never repeat gimmicks.
Mario Kart wants to have a word with you.
Yeah, but they don't.
The glider and the underwater sections were repeated.
No, those aren't items.
They're not.
No, the gimmick was 3D. That's what won't come back.
Okay.
You gotta think like Nintendo. You have to get in their crazy head.
And if you want to say the gimmick of Mario Kart 7 was 3D, you could literally apply that to every 3DS game.
That is exactly what Nintendo does. I wish I was kidding, but like, that's why like 3D Land is so basic, because it's just like, oh yeah, this is 3D, but the gimmick is that we can have depth of field now.
Whatever. Nintendo 64 Switch Online finally gets announced. It starts with 10 games, including Smash Bros., Mario Kart 64, and GoldenEye. And the GameCube Switch Online is confirmed at the tail end of this year or sometime next year, in 2022, and it will be implemented sometime in mid-2022. Mario RPG gets a re-release alongside, with multiple Final Fantasy games from the SNES era. In the SNES online. I'd say those are pretty pie in the sky, out of this world, and unfucking likely as all get out.
I'd say impossible.
I'm surprised you didn't mention Persona 4 and 5 on the Switch.
You know, actually, now that you mention it, I'm actually going to go out and say yes. Those two, maybe not both the next, maybe not both this year, but I'd imagine at least one of them because it's Persona's 25th anniversary.
I mean, what I would like is Persona 4 to end up on the PS4. Or, and just use the Steam version and just use that as a base for the PS4 version.
Well, we'd all like to hope.
And then,
Let's not forget the Trails series is also celebrating an anniversary this year. I forget what, but yeah, so it's looking likely that there will also be some re-releases, like the first two Trails of Cold Steel games on the Switch in Japan. Prediction is they'll get localized. The Crossbow games are coming, so that too.
Number one hope is that Epic Games wins the lawsuit against Apple. That would be awesome.
Wait,
there's a lawsuit with Apple? What's going on with that?
Okay, so, wait. Like,
it's Fortnite.
Epic Games? Yeah, that's Fortnite. They don't like how Apple takes a portion of the microtransactions. Like, because they take a big cut. They take, like, a huge percent. I forget what it is, but it's pretty ridiculous.
Probably, like, 40%.
Yeah, it's like, and that's on all apps. So you, like, think of just how much money, like, Clash Royale fucking makes. And then it's like, oh, Apple gets 40% of that shit. And it's like, Wow. Yeah, so Epic Games, what they're suing Apple about is, like, we should be able to start our own app store. And we can't do that legally. So it's like, that's fucking bullshit. Because Apple just outright controls everything. And on Google, on Androids, Google controls everything.
Oh, okay, okay. I will admit, while I've had problems with Epic Games, like, in the past, like, that is kind of dumb. Like, yeah. like, Epic Games is the reason why I had to get a fucking PlayStation 4 version of Hitman and Hitman 2. Because I can't have the content on my... those games, like, transfer content into Hitman 3, which I wanted to get. But now that I... Now that it's that way and it's exclusive to the Epic Game Store for a whole year, I can't do that.
Yeah, but I think, like, for the sake of competition and so, like, because it makes them have to be less, like, predatory with microtransactions because they make it cost more so they can, like, get around the amount of money they're losing, so it'll make them less predatory. Epic Games might be policed better so they don't get, like, all the fucking terrible apps that are on the Apple Store and especially the Google Play Store. And I think, like, that's just going to, like, really help the games industry, especially on, like, iPhone smartphones, which really need, like, good-ass games on them.
Yeah. Alright. Alright, so as we wrap things up, I'd like to... say one thing, one very important lesson that I learned last year that I hope everyone else takes into account. If you can't find something on the Google Play Store in terms of movies and television, go to Amazon Video because they pretty much have everything else.
Okay, I've everything.
Okay. I mean, you could do that, but I'd rather at least try to get things legally first. But if that doesn't work, you know. Anyway, yeah. Because for the longest time, I was trying to get some of these things like Pokemon Diamond and Pearl on Google Play for the longest time. Like, I was literally almost campaigning the fucking thing to happen for years. Then I realized that it's all on Amazon. It's like, what? So, yeah. Suffice to say, I'm going to be spending a lot of money on Amazon going forward.
I think that's a good place to close it off.
Fair enough. All right. So, our editorial lasted almost as much as regular episodes, so that fucking failed.
We tried to make it shorter.
But yeah, it's fine. We're just glad that the old year is out and the new year can finally begin. And I at least hope that
Can we argue Pokemon?
We can't argue, Pokemon. You won't let me. I gotta finish Digimon first.
No, no, like, that's... When you're done with Digimon, we'll do that fucking podcast episode.
I'd have to fucking quit my job and literally spend, like, 2 weeks to do that fucking shit. But
no, Digimon is not that... If you watch one episode a day, you could do it pretty reasonably.
I mean, I'm not saying that I can't do that. I'm just saying that I'd rather get it done faster than that. And, like, don't get me wrong, I'd love to quit my job, but, you know, money. But, yeah.
No, there's 20 days in a month, at least. And
yeah, 20 days. Yeah, more like 30.
No, it depends on the month. Well, February is 28, but like, yeah, you have essentially 30 days on average each month. So that's 30 episodes out of Digimon. I forget how many it is, but like
51.
Yeah, so literally you can finish that in 2 months just watching one a day.
Fair enough. All right. Enough of our future plans. Pokemon will come in its own time. All right. So yeah. We're gonna go on a bit of a hiatus until things die down a little bit from the holidays. So expect the next episode sometime mid to late January.
Okay.
All right. So this is Blast 6.
Red.
And Equestron.
We're signing off and saying a big last fuck you to 2020.
See you in hell.
Fuck 2020.
Now it's time for so long. But we'll sing one more song.
Now it's time for so long. But we'll sing one.